Hello everyone, welcome to Mathematics Solution Channel, and in this video we are going to discuss about how to verify the Lagrange's mean value theorem for the particular function. Okay, here I have a question, that is verify the Lagrange's mean value theorem for the function f of x is equal to x minus 1 times x minus 2 into x minus 3 in the closed interval 0, 4. So the first we need to recall what is the Lagrange's mean value theorem. The first thing, f of x is continuous in the closed interval. In general we can say that a comma b, here they are given 0, 4. And second thing, f of x is differentiable in the open interval 0, 4. If these two conditions satisfied, then the f dash of c is equal to f of b minus f of a by b minus a for some c belongs to open interval of a comma b. Now these are the three conditions for the Lagrange's mean value theorem. Now we will verify one by one. What is the first condition? The given function should be continuous. So given f of x is equal to x minus 1 into x minus 2 then x minus 3, okay, in the closed interval 0, 4. Now if you substitute 0, so you will get finite value. If you apply 4 again, you will get finite value, so don't worry about that. So the given function f of x is continuous in the closed interval 0, 4. Second thing, we want to find the derivative of this particular function. How to find derivative? Already we have f of x. If we find the derivative of this f of x, yeah, we can say that obviously it is having the differentiable in the 0, 4 and the given interval. And before that, this is a somewhat complicated terms, right? So I am going to simplify this. So as here is f of x is equal to x minus 1, x minus 2, then into x minus 3. Now we can simplify here, so this will become x square minus 3x minus plus 2 into again x minus 3. This will give x power 3 minus 3x square, again 3x square and plus 2x, and before that it is plus 9x plus 2x and minus 6. This f of x will become x power 3 minus 6x square plus 11x minus 6. Now we got f of x. While finding f dash of x, so this will become more easier. So f dash of x is equal to, so x power 3 will become 3x square minus 12x plus 11. Yes, now f of x is differentiable in the open interval 0, 4. Now directly we will go to this function f dash of c is equal to f of b minus f of a divided by b minus a. And before that we want to find what is f of b, f of a. Now here the a value is 0 and here is b. These are called n points of this given interval. So f of 0 is equal to, substitute 0 in this value, so you will get minus 1 into minus 2 into minus 3, so this will become minus 6. Then f of 4 is equal to 1, so 4 minus 1, then 2 into 3, so this will become 6. Now we got all the values. Now substitute directly in this third condition, f dash of c is equal to f of b minus f of a divided by b minus a. Now f of c, f dash of c, already we know f dash of x, let it be number 1, right? We know f dash of x. While finding f dash of c, just replace x as c, you will get 3c square minus 12c plus 11, which is equal to f of b, that is f of 4 minus, that is 6 minus of minus 6 divided by 4 minus 0. Now 3c square minus 12c plus 11 which is equal to 6 plus 6, so 12 by 4, which is equal to 3. Which is equal to 3. Now bring all the terms one side. So 3c square minus 12c plus 8 is equal to 0. Now this is a quadratic equation in C. Now you know this has two solution or two roots. Maybe the both the roots lies between the open interval of 0, 4, or we know at least one root maybe lies inside the open interval of 0, 4. Now we'll verify it. Before that, we want to find the roots of this particular equation so that it is not possible to use the factor method. So I am going to use the formula, that is minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac. So minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2 into a. And here, you know, a value here is a is equal to 3 and b is equal to minus 12 and c is equal to 8. Substitute here. If you substitute c is equal to here, you will get 12 plus or minus square root of 144 minus 4 into 3 into 8. So that will become 96 divided by 2 into 3 will become 6. Now simplify 12 plus or minus square root of this 144 minus 96 will become 48 divided by 6. And here 48 can be written as 16 into 3. So 12 plus or minus, that 16 can be written as 4 times of root 3 divided by 6. Now if you simplify, because 2 is common here, then we can write 6 plus or minus 2 root 3 divided by 6. Sorry, 2 root 3 divided by 3. So this is the C value. Now here we have two values. Here C is equal to 6 plus 2 root 3 divided by 3 and 6 minus 2 root 3 divided by 3. We have two values. If you simplify, C is equal to 3.15 and another value C is equal to 0.85. Now look at the given interval. What's the given interval? It is 0, 4. So definitely this also lies between 0, 4 and this value also lies between the open interval of 0, 4. Now look at here, the statement says that after the second condition, then there exists at least one value C of X in the open interval a, b such that f dash of C is equal to f of b minus f of a divided by b minus a. They said that at least you can get minimum one value, right? So maybe you can expect more than one. So that is what happened here. So here we got the two value, 3.15 and 0.85. So this is how we can prove the Lagrange's mean value theorem for any given function.